Hi, this is Paul, and we are in exciting Las Vegas again, and we had the most incredible thing at my presentation. We had a real life robot, a 400-pound, 5-foot robot come, and we are lucky enough that we have the CEO of Knightscope, and Knightscope is the company that makes this robot K5. Bill, welcome.
And hey, thanks for having us.
Thanks for
really
coming.
Appreciate
thanks
it.
For bringing K5.
No, absolutely,
400 pounds. I love it. Big boy.
Yeah, I've got some folks that are like, hey, just bring it on the plane with you. I'm like, I don't think you understand.
I was telling you in the presentation that it's got the perfect size for a security robot, because I think of, like, you know, you'd want something that you couldn't really move physically.
Yes, so we actually have, we're kind of like a police officer, needs to stand up straight, command, respect, and authority, shiny shoes, but you can't scare grandma or the child, right? You have to have just the right balance of, maybe I'm gonna do a double take before I do something silly. So that's the way it is.
Yeah, so many of readers have heard about robots and robotics, and obviously I gave this presentation about robotics, always a great investment opportunity. But tell us a little bit about Knightscope and about K5 and you know, that our readers would be interested in.
Sure. So I think the next 10 years, the world's gonna change more than the last 100 years combined. We started Knightscope 5 years ago, one out of personal motivation and one professional. On the professional side, I'm an ex-Ford Motor Company executive. I think autonomous technology is going to turn the world completely upside down. All its self-driving technology, it's been about $80 billion invested in the sector, nearly 50 companies working on it. And have you seen a self-driving car generating revenue anywhere around here? No.
No.
Right. So Knightscope is the worldwide leader in commercializing self-driving technology. We're operating in 16 states, running 24/7 across 4 time zones. So we've taken a completely different path to commercialize that very profound technology. Mm-hmm. On the personal side, I was born in New York City. Someone hit my town on 9/11. I'm still really upset about it. Yeah. So I'm dedicating the rest of my life to better securing our country.
Yeah, I was in New York for 9/11 too. That was brutal.
Yeah.
I mean, I was thinking about that. So was that the inspiration for creating Knightscope?
Yeah, so I love my country, but it's structurally flawed in trying to stop all the crime and violence. So most people don't realize that crime has a $1 trillion negative economic impact on the US every single year. So if you add up all the handcuffs, all the prisons, all the judges, all the ambulances, it's a hidden tax we all pay in blood, tears, and treasure.
Right.
And every time something goes wrong, our political leaders on both sides of the aisle stand up and say what? Oh, we extend our thoughts and prayers.
Right.
Hey, buddy, like, that's not gonna fix the problem. So structurally, if you want to look at it from a macro political economic perspective, there's a $700 billion budget that the US Department of Defense manages. There's one person in charge, a Secretary of Defense. There's a huge military complex to build whatever widget you want. Northrop, Lockheed, Raytheon, Boeing, right? And there's a process, and if you want a new submarine or new widget or new tank, like, there's a way to deliver that. What's structurally flawed and a huge economic opportunity and an opportunity to make a big positive impact on society is the US Department of Homeland Security and the US Department of Justice has no federal jurisdiction over 8,000 private security firms and 19,000 law enforcement agencies. And there's literally no one in charge. So that's why over the last 100 years, there's been no innovation in the security space, because there's no capital going into the sector, there's no leadership, there's no process, there's no anything. And what we see is gold in them hills.
Yeah.
Right. There is a huge problem.
Right.
And here's a new technology that we're able to start helping society fix it. And our long-term ambition is to make the United States of America the safest country in the world, changing everything for everyone. So if we're able to do that, the volatility of financial markets, the safety of your family, the viability of someone's local business, housing prices, insurance rates, like, literally everything changes for everyone.
So we had K5, which is your biggest robot.
Yep.
You know, you were kind enough to bring it to my presentation. Yeah, it's spectacular. So what are, like, what are the economics of like of having like could I you know like since there a neighborhood organization wanted to have it. Is that something that's viable today?
Yeah,
like
absolutely.
You know, could like a HOA say, hey,
yeah, we have clients that are absolutely.
Okay.
So the economics, loosely speaking, because this ranges across the country.
Right.
But if you want an off-duty law enforcement officer that's armed to stand out your office or your home, it's about $85 an hour.
Okay.
If you want a security guard to patrol your premises, what the client pays, not what the guard gets paid, is around $25 an hour, and it ranges widely depending on, again, what you want her or him to do. We offer our machines on a machine as a service business model at an effective price of $6 to $12 an hour. So it's a massive cost reduction for a lot of our clients that spend $50 or $100 million a year on security guards, right? The security guard industry is a bit broken. So the employee turnover rates are about 100 to 400%.
Right.
Awful customer service, awful focus on technology, awful margins as one staffing business. And it's a very difficult commodity.
It's a brutal job. I mean, your job is just to like walk around. Endlessly.
But the intersection is really important. So now you've got a profound set of technologies. You've got a price point that's really attractive for a client.
Right.
So why does an investor care? Well, the investor cares because our clients sign 1, 2, or 3 year long contracts. Roughly there's $70,000 to $100,000 a year of revenue that comes in per machine. And let's just round up to make it easy numbers. So I'm an ex-auto executive. You expect me to make sure that machine lasts for 5 years.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
So 5 years in service, $100,000 a year of revenue comes into the company. That's a $500,000 of revenue per machine over that 5 year period.
Gotcha.
And then there's some operating costs, it costs us money to build the machine, et cetera, but you're gonna probably net out around $250,000 of profit per machine over that 5 year period.
Right.
That's why economically it gets really, really attractive. And so you've got kind of hardware automotive per unit economics, meaning the dollar per machine is really high, but you've got SaaS or software as a service margins, right? And you know, when I was back in Detroit, like we could barely cover our cost of capital. I mean, you look at the after-tax return on sales and it's like 1, 2, 3%, you know, kind of hanging on, like not a viable business.
Right. This is why Elon Musk was saying there's only two auto companies that have never gone bankrupt, Tesla and Ford.
Yep.
And they both just barely made it by the skin of their teeth in 2008.
That yeah.
They barely made it, So what is like, you know, where are the growth prospects in your business? Like where's Knightscope going? Like, I mean, are you going to stay in security? Or is there like, is that the business plan? Like just like, it's a large market. However, it's a difficult market, but that makes it also where no one's likely to come.
So 95% of startups fail.
Okay.
80% never make it past the third anniversary.
Right.
50% fail the first year.
Right.
Right. One of the problems is the CEO is not willing to say no. And we've got a lot of investors pushing us this way and that way. We've got nearly 6,000 folks that have backed the company.
Right.
And we've got to be able to laser focus on the mission. What is it that we're trying to accomplish? We're trying to make the U.S. the safest country in the world. Like going off and working on mapping or doing delivery, like that's not going to help.
Right.
If you add up globally, the private and public sector, how much is spent annually on security? It's $500 trillion.
Right, right.
So when someone asks me like, hey, you should go work on delivery, like I don't think that's probably a good use of time.
Yeah, yeah, you got plenty. You got plenty where this is out there.
Yeah, yeah.
And you're in 4 countries, you said, right?
No. So we're operating 4 time zones, US only.
US only,
We're in 16 states right now and growing significantly, primarily in the logistics healthcare. You know, we're at LaGuardia Airport, so that's starting to grow. We're in casinos, Westfield malls, corporate campuses like Citizens Bank, BlackRock. You know, BlackRock manages $6 trillion, big money manager. Samsung, Seagate's a client, and now we're starting to grow significantly, and that's why we're raising our pre-IPO financing now. So a few years ago, the federal government changed the rules that allow private companies to do public offerings but remain private, so the stock doesn't trade.
Right.
So you can literally go to Knightscope.com and buy in at $8 a share for accredited investors.
Okay. Well, it's been a great conversation.
Absolutely.
Thanks
for having us.
Bringing K5.
Sure,
it's been
great.
Thank
Very
you
good.
So much.
Cheers.
Thank you. So that was the CEO of Knightscope, and you've got to go check out the robot at Knightscope.com, and you can contact Bill through there.